El día de hoy estamos con una de las estrellas, uno de los talentos match que no se pueden perder y que a lo largo de la programación del día escuchan más de una ocasión. Hosier, hi, how you doing?
Hey, very well, thank you.
Welcome to Match 99.3 FM. Welcome to Mexico. How do you feel about being here?
So good. I played a few years ago, you know, played to one of the best audiences I have ever performed in front of here in the city. So to be back I'm really excited.
The city loves you. Oh. Yeah. And loves your music and loves your work. You have a new album that comes out the last year.
Yes.
How do you feel with that?
I feel good. You know, it's been a joy to kind of tour that album. I'm hoping to release songs, unreleased songs from that collection of work later in the year, like soon, you know. So it's been super fun. I'm touring with a great band, great musicians, in front of some great people. This is the first show of the year for us. So our first show after Christmas, we took a break. So we're all kind of excited.
We're so excited about your shows in Mexico City. Now, I have to say this, and sorry about it. You're one of the biggest songwriters on the music industry today.
Oh, wow.
We love your music. We love the way that you write your songs. And we want to know about the creative process behind the songwriting.
Yeah. Sometimes it can be slow, you know. I write most of my work I've written on my own, but it takes me a while. I could write six songs at the same time, but their progress is slow. On the new album, I decided to sort of just throw ideas around with people. I'd never written with other people before, so I just got into a room with, like, you know, drums and guitar and keys and just jammed with a few guys and saw what happened. And that was fun. It was kind of exciting and a new way of doing it. But for me, generally, like, especially with the lyrics, they take me a long, long time. With the words, take me a long, long time. I'll sit with them and kind of figure out.
Do you have some kind of creative blocks or something like that?
It can happen, yeah, for sure. Like during, years ago during the pandemic, you know, when I was kind of living alone in the countryside, didn't see many people for a long, long time. So I think I just slowed down creatively. I just kind of slowed down. So it can happen. But I think what the best thing to do is when you start to get frustrated with that, it's you sort of just allow the block to happen, work on something else. Don't keep, you know what I mean? Find some other route, and eventually it'll open up the, you know.
And what about when you're not making music or writing music or living around the music world? Mm-hmm. What do you like to do?
Oh my goodness. I spend so much time in the music world. I wish I had more hobbies.
I don't have a life.
Yeah, I don't have a life. Yeah, I've been out of a suitcase now for over a year. I do. I mean, I love when I'm home. You know, I love to cook. You know, I love to cook when I'm home. I love to, like, I live in the countryside. I love going for walks. I live by the sea, so I love swimming. And then just seeing friends. You know, seeing buddies from mine that I've known forever, like, we'll just hang out like we're still in school, like, you know, that's, you know,
yeah,
simple stuff.
I realized that a lot of people that make music or something like that, they love to cook.
Yeah,
I don't know why.
Interesting.
because it's similar to making music or something like that.
Maybe, I guess it is. I mean, I think cooking is an art form, you know.
Yeah.
I think culinary arts, you know, and I think it's creative, you know, it can be creative. But also, if you're on the road, if you're on tour, you never see a kitchen, you never cook for yourself. You do a lot of, you know, if we're on a bus, like, maybe I'll press a button on a coffee machine. That's the extent, you know what I mean? So
yeah,
when you get home and you can actually cook again, it feels good.
Yeah. Do you have a personal chef?
No.
No, I have to
I'm
ask.
Not there. A few more trips, you know, a few more gigs, and we'll see. No.
Okay. And what's on your catering when you're on tour?
My catering. I don't have a personal chef yet. Oh yeah, for touring. No, actually, we don't have a personal chef. But catering, we try to keep it healthy because it's easy to fall into bad habits on the road. You
okay,
know.
Okay. Yeah.
So, yeah. I mean, you're gonna try to keep it healthy.
And you're a swimmer.
I swim.
You have to keep it in shape.
Yeah, to an extent.
Or the indoor activities.
Yeah, I don't work out a huge amount. You can probably tell. I don't work out, you know, I'm not that image conscious. You know, I'm not thinking about how I look half the time. But I love swimming. I love walking. I don't know. Yeah, that's about, I keep it simple. Yeah.
I have to know that because I think that your work works for take a walk, for example, right, or being on a road trip, yeah, or a kind of a meditation, right, when you're walking around alone and you're thinking about a lot of things that happened in your life.
Yeah.
And that's the reason that I ask you this, because we want to know the source of your inspiration to make music.
Totally. Yeah, know? 100%. I think, and the ideas do come from me, you know, they come to me when I'm either in the water or while I'm walking, or if I do have a block, a creative block, sometimes I'll go for a walk with the idea in my ears, you know, and then I'll take a break from it. But somewhere on the walk, the idea comes. So I'm writing when I'm walking.
And you're I don't know how to say this, a phone person. I mean, that you're writing on the notes of the cell phone, or just on paper.
Yes, on the cell phone, voice memos. You know, like hundreds of voice memos, just like
the voice memos works very good. No,
yeah, super easy.
Because it's like something else giving you advice, but it's you.
Yeah, true. Yeah, no? You kind of come back like 2 weeks later, and you're like, oh my god, yeah, this. You know what I mean? You're like, totally forgot about that. So, yeah.
And what about the songs on this creative process? Mm-hmm. Did you write songs of making music in this way?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Sometimes I'll look back. I mean, sometimes it's hard to interpret. Like, you look back at a voice memo where it's 3 a.m, 4 a.m, you've woken up from a dream, and you've got like, so it's like a half voice memo, and you're trying to make sense of like, is that a melody, or is that, am I trying to say something? You know, I would use a voice memo. And sometimes if I am stuck, actually, if I feel like I have no ideas, I'll go back a year ago at voice memos that I've totally forgotten about and remember some little thing that I was once excited about and start from there.
Do you have any song that you remind you of this process?
Yeah. So there's a song on the new record called To Someone From a Warm Climate, Ishkordaha. And if I look back like a year ago, there's like a rough version of me singing a melody and words like that, but it's like very different. It's like finger pick acoustic guitar. It's like a folk, it's like a real happy song, you know, it's like super cheery sounding. So it's very different, but it's, you know, there's an early version of it somewhere.
Yeah. Now, we want to know that you love collect music and I don't know, listen to someone else's work. Mm-hmm. What kind of work inspires your creative journey?
Yeah, it can depend. So there's like, I'm always listening to like old stuff. Like, I was a huge fan as a teenager, like the Beatles, and obviously, you know, writers like Paul Simon and like David Bowie and Leonard Cohen. And but at the moment, like, I was really enjoying Boy Genius. You know, I love Phoebe Bridgers. I love her writings. You know, Big Thief is a band I was listening to a lot recently. Adrienne Lenker, and her writing is staggeringly good. There's an artist called Mitski as well. I'm a big fan of Mitski. I love Mitski.
Yeah, we love Mitski.
She's amazing. She's just so unique. So it depends. It's kind of from different spots here and there, you know. Yeah.
I want to ask you something about the positivity in your work. You're a personal, I think that a reflective artist. You're very critical. You're against the grain or something like that on your music.
Right.
You know.
Right.
How's the mix that between being sensitive and being I don't know how to say this, very raw at your lyrics?
Yeah. I think I don't know. Yeah. I think that can be challenging, because I think there's definitely the challenge is maybe how to distill into words, or in a 3-minute song or in a 4-minute song, something that maybe I feel strongly about, or I feel passionately about, or something I'm, you know, that can be a challenge. And because you can't sum up everything that you think and everything that you feel into a short piece of music. Especially if you're talking about an issue or something that's a difficult subject. So you kind of just have to be at peace in somewhat with these gestures or these offerings of, you know, you're recognizing this the actuality of some feeling or some thing. But that can be tough, that can be challenging. But I think as long as I just try to be steered by what's honest, what feels honest to me, and hopefully that will suffice.
Yeah, it feels very honest.
Oh,
yeah, I had to say this. And finally, I want to ask you, how do you feel in this time of your life? Are you happy?
I think so. I am. Happiness is like happiness is like, I don't know. It's like trying to, what was I trying to say? It's like, it's like mindfulness or peace. It's like a sense of peace. It's like the game. Don't think about blue elephants. You know what I mean? It's like, as soon as you start thinking, okay, I won't think about blue elephants, you've already lost the game. Happiness is like, I think the more you start thinking about what's going to make you happy, I'm just trying to be present. I'm so grateful. I'm so effing grateful. Like, I'm grateful to be here. I'm grateful to have this life and have this career, make this music and have an audience that wants to listen to it. And to me, and like my family, my friends, like, so in that respect, yeah, I'm so happy.
And you have a point. Be present is one of the biggest, I don't know how to say it, journeys to be happy.
Yeah.
If you're present and on your life and you're grateful with your time, with your people, the life provides you of happiness, the true happiness.
I think so. I started doing this, if I had a bad few weeks, you know, I started reminding myself I can't always do this, but like when I have a bad, really bad day or some challenging bad news or something, I try to say thank you. Or I'm like, okay, thank you for, you know what I mean? Like, you stubbed my toe. Anything big, anything small. And I'm like, thank you. Even if I don't mean it, I'm like, no, this is good. This is, and I try to be grateful for anything, but like, and I find it helps. It really does help, you know. But I'm so great. I'm a happy man right now.
Yeah, and we're so happy to be here with you, talking about your music, about your work, about your way of life, about your way of being happy, and everything. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for making music like this, because we really appreciate it. And we hope to see you soon again in Mexico City.
Absolutely.
And releasing new music. And finally, we want to know about the works that your mom does on your cover albums.
Oh,
because
yeah.
Because I really love it.
On the artwork, yeah. So she painted the first album. She painted the second album cover. You know, the third album, we weren't able to, we did, time was against us. I was trying to get an album out, trying to record it and produce it during the pandemic. It was very, very difficult, but we might work together. She's an artist, you know, she's a painter, but we might collaborate again on something in the future. But
hope to see you.
Yeah, and thank you so much for the support.
Thank you so much for your music. We really love it. Thank you so much for being here, and hope you enjoy your visit on Mexico City.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Gracias.
Who's here? En Match 99.3. Quédense por acá. No olviden escuchar su música. No olviden que también tenemos por ahí el material del que ya platicamos. Chequen todas las entrevistas que tenemos en nuestro canal de YouTube @MatchMXFM y escuchen toda la música de Who's Here a lo largo de la República Mexicana en la cadena Match. Soy Miguel Miranda. Cami fuera. Thank you so much.
Gracias.